Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you an easy way to identify texture stretching to find out if we need to edit our UVs using a simple built-in texture. I'm going to left click my already unwrapped cylinder here. If you want to learn how to unwrap a cylinder, make sure to check out my video on UV unwrapping cylinders. And then I'm going to left click and drag up my timeline here. And where the clock is, I'm going to left click it and change it to shader editor. Then where it says plus new, I'm just going to left click it, and here it's going to add our basic principal BSDF and material output. We're not going to be able to see anything right now because we need to go into our viewport shading. So I'll left click it here, and right now it's going to display our object as black. This is because of the new updated Eevee in Blender 4.2 and onwards, which means we'll have to check a few additional settings. So I'm going to left click and drag this panel here to pull it out. And in order to change our material preview settings here, we'll need to go into Eevee since it uses the Eevee render engine. So I'll change from cycles to Eevee, then I'm going to scroll down to ray tracing, open up the panel. Again, this is Blender 4.2, so if you're in an earlier version, you won't need to do this. And then I'm going to left click the box to check it, and then I'm going to change my max roughness to 1 by just left clicking it and then typing the number 1. You can also just drag this bar. If you want to render in cycles later, you can just go ahead and change your render engine back to cycles, and you can see all the settings we changed in Eevee render engine have still been saved. Back to what we were talking about, I'm going to come back to my shader editor here, and I'm going to press Shift A to open the add menu. And under texture, I'm just going to choose image texture. Then I can simply press this plus new button. And here we're just going to call this UV grid. I'll keep the width and height at the default, which is 1K. And generated type, I'm going to change from blank to UV grid. Then I'll just left click new image. And before we even plug this in, we need to make sure it's using the UV map coordinates. If you want to see our UV map, I'm just going to press tab in object mode and press A to select everything. You can see that I've unwrapped this object already here. I'll press Shift A, and then under input, I'm going to choose texture coordinate, and we're going to plug UV into vector. This is good practice because we're essentially understanding that we're needing to use the UV coordinate, which is the information from here, to tell this texture how to be displayed on our object. I'll plug my color into base color, and now if I press tab to go back to object mode, you can see we've got all these squares, and as long as these squares are squares, that means we have very minimal texture stretching. However, if I was to come into this UV editor and, for example, maybe press L to select this island here and press S and then X to scale it on the X axis, you can see if I come to my bottom face here, our texture is very distorted. And to fix that, all we would need to do is straighten up this UV by pressing S and X again. And now that's allowed me to scale it to roughly so it's back to squares again. So essentially, you want to try and make sure that this texture is made up of just these squares, because a square indicates that there is minimal texture stretching. That means when you apply one of your actual textures, there's not going to be any hidden stretching which will make it look off, but you're not quite sure how to fix it. And yeah, that just about covers it. If you want to learn more about UV unwrapping, such as the fundamental concepts and other quick tips like these, make sure to check out my free beginner playlist for UV unwrapping in Blender. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.